Hello students, I am Dr. Shumaila from Department of Anthropology, University of Delhi. Today I am going to speak on the module Dermatoglyphics from the paper Research Methods and Fieldwork. The objective of this module are to identify fingerprints, to classify and compare fingerprints, to classify palm prints, and to identify and classify sole prints. So let's start with a brief introduction of Dermatoglyphics. Dermatoglyphics is the scientific study of prints or impressions formed by palms, fingers, soles and toes. While the term dermatoglyphics is derived from Greek words derma meaning skin and glyph meaning carving. Also there is science of comparison of friction ridge is called as dactyloscopy. The largest organ of the human body is skin, which covers the body's outer surface and performs the functions such as protection of internal organs and receiving of external stimuli. So the texture of skin on the entire human body is neither same nor smooth. The skin, especially on inner side of hands, that is palms and fingers, and feet, that is soles and toes, are raised in the form of structure of rows separated by furs or depressions. So these elevated portions of the skin are called as friction ridges or dermal ridges. The main function of these friction ridges is to impart gripping. Every friction ridge contains sweat pores. The perspiration discharged from these sweat glands along with dead skin cells, proteins, fats and material creates impression of the ridges on the surface of contact. Thus, the surface from which fingerprints are obtained displays an accurate representation of the print. So, the impression from the friction ridges of fingers of hand or feet are collectively called as fingerprints, whereas those obtained from volar surface, that is palm of hand and sole of feet, are referred as palm prints and sole prints respectively. Now let's talk about various dermatoglyphics prints. Okay, so first is visible prints. Those prints which are visible through naked eyes are called as visible prints. For example, blood print, mud print, dust print and ink print. Second one is plastic print. The print formed on the materials that forms molds after coming in contact surfaces such as wax, butter, ghee, semi-dry paint or putty, cements are termed as plastic paints. All plastic paints are visible paints. And the third is latent prints. Those prints which are not visible through naked eyes are designated as latent. These prints are developed with the help of some chemicals. Now let's talk about the morphogenesis of friction ridges. The friction ridge first appears between 12th and 16th week of gestational age of embryo and estimated to be completed by 24th week. The major development of friction ridges occur between 11 and 20 weeks of estimated gestational age. After the morphogenesis of friction ridge, let's discuss about the fingerprints. And in this first, we will discuss about the fundamental principles of fingerprints. So fingerprint study involves analysis and comparison of friction ridge patterns present on the anterior surface of the fingers. Though the general term fingerprint is used, but all principles mentioned below applies to palm and sole print as well. So fingerprint is an individual characteristics. So the statement implies that no two individuals or fingers of the same person can have the same fingerprint. Identical twins may have a similar fingerprints, but not their fingerprints are not absolutely identical. So the individuality of a print is imparted not by its shape or pattern, but by its specific ridge features, which are called minutiae. The type and locations of specific minutiae impart the uniqueness to the fingerprint. And this uniqueness is the basis for fingerprint comparison. In other words, two individuals may have similar fingerprint pattern, but due to difference in the type, number and position of minutiae, the two fingerprints can be differentiated. Fingerprints remain unchanged during a lifetime. Once formed, the friction ridges only increase in size in due course of time without any change in their pattern throughout the life of an individual until skin decomposes or an injury is so deep that it destroys dermal papillae. Fingerprints have general ridge patterns that permit them to be classified. The arrangement of friction ridges on the fingers is found in three forms, namely loops, whorls, and arcs. So these three patterns form the basis of fingerprint classification system used for comparison and keeping records. Before defining various types of fingerprint pattern, it is important to understand the basic fingerprint features that make up the fingerprint pattern. As described earlier, fingerprints are the impression of ridges left behind on the surface. So the pattern area is like the outer boundaries of fingerprint patterns in which core, delta, and type lines are present. The first feature of fingerprint is delta, which is also known as triradius. It is that region on the fingerprint where the outermost ridge on the pattern area diverge. So this diversion causes a space where other types lines exist. The second is type line. Those ridges which are used in classifying the various types of the fingerprint patterns are called as type line. And the third is core. As the name implies, it approximately the central point of the fingerprint pattern. Now we will discuss about the comparison of a single fingerprint. The ridges don't exist as continuous running lines. They can bifurcate or may exist in the form of small dot. All these features are important and used in comparing fingerprints. Matching of minimum 8 ridge features are generally prescribed for proving the similarity of fingerprints. Some of the important features of friction ridges which are used in establishing identity are short ridge, it is a small size ridge, dot, it is a small round ridge, bifurcation and trifurcation, a ridge splitting into two or three ridges respectively is called bifurcation and trifurcation. Enclosure, when a single ridge split into two and these two forked ridges again converges and continues as a single ridge, that formation is called as enclosure or island. Hook or spur, it is a ridge bifurcating into two but only one of the bifurcation continues ahead. Bridge, when a ridge bifurcates into two and one of the bifurcation runs ahead whereas the other bifurcation joins with adjacent parallel ridge, and bridge-like structure is formed connecting two parallel running ridges. Ridge ending, a ridge running between two other ridges and ending up abruptly is called as ridge ending. Intersection, two ridges cutting each other are called as intersecting ridges. Ridge count, it is the number of ridges which cut or cross the imaginary line drawn between core and delta constitutes ridge count. Ridge count excludes counting core and delta. Now we know about the fingerprints, let's move to its classification. The type lines on the finger ball exist in the form of unique patterns. These patterns are primarily identified as arc, loop, and whorls. On the basis of absence, presence, and the number of delta and cores. Arc, they are the least frequent and simple type of pattern in the human population. Arcs are characterized on the basis of absence of both core and delta. They can be further subcategorized as plane and tentin arcs. So in plane arc, the type lines can be seen flowing gently from one side of the finger ball to the other. Whereas in tentin arc, pattern, the loop of the ridge is almost vertical. So the loops are the most frequent type of fingerprint patterns. They are characterized by the presence of one delta and one core. Loops can be further subcategorized as radial loop and ulnar loop on the basis of slanting of ridges towards ulnar or radial direction. If the ridges enter and exit from the little finger side, that loop pattern is termed as ulnar loop. And if it enters and exits from the thumb side, that loop pattern is termed as radial loop. So let's discuss about whorls now. Whorls are second most common type of fingerprints. They are characterized by the presence of two deltas and one or more core. So they can be further subclassified as plain whorl, double loop, central pocket loop and accidental. So the plain whorl is the simplest type of whorl having two deltas and one core. So the type lines are arranged either in circular or spherical fashion around the core, giving it the image like that of disturbance of water in the pond after being hit by the pebble. So the central pocket loop also possesses two delta and one single core. So the central loop prints look like a loop print having a whorl in the central position. It can be differentiated from the plain whorl on the basis of positioning of deltas. If the imaginary line joining the two delta cut across the ridges and circling the core, then the pattern is plain whorl. And if it does not cross through the ridges forming circle around the core, then the pattern is classified as central loop whorl. Double loop, also known as lateral loop or composite whorl or twin, is the composition of two loops. So these two loops may open in same direction or in opposite direction. Accidental one is the pattern which cannot be classified in any of the above mentioned categories. They may have two or more than two deltas and often exist as various combination of loops and whorls. Once fingerprints are developed and identified as various types, the next step is to carry out the comparison of fingerprints. The main purpose of comparison is to identify a person from his or her fingerprint. To collect information, the fingerprint from the scene of crime or from the suspect is first collected on a tan print card or on a live scan. Live scan is a digital version of print card. Although the use of technology for recording and compiling has made the task of classification easy, but given the vast amount of already existing fingerprints record and matching it with that of fingerprint under study can still be a daunting task. So to ease the process of fingerprint comparison, Sir Edward Henry developed the first alphabet numeric system of fingerprint classification. Henry's system of classification consisted of four divisions, namely primary, secondary, subsecondary, and final, to which later on key and major system of classifications were added. So now let's talk about the primary classification. The 10 print card has blocks written in sequence starting with right thumb to right little finger to left thumb to left little finger. Each block is assigned a number starting from 1 to right thumb to 10 to left little finger. For the purpose of classification, first of all, examine each fingerprint on the 10-digit card and determine their types. In this classification, only whorls are identified and all types of whorl are categorized as whorls. So the first two boxes, that is box 1 and 2, having the fingerprint impression of right thumb and right index finger are assigned the value of 16. if the whorl pattern occurs in it. In case of loop and arc, zero value is given. Similarly, value of 8 is given to the next two block, 3 and 4, followed by 4 to next two. Box number 7 and 8 has a value of 2, and to the last 2, 9 and 10, the value is 1. So the formula for primary classification is sum of all even digit handy value plus 1, or R index ring plus L thumb plus L middle plus little plus 1. So sum of all odd digits handy value plus 1 plus right thumb plus right middle little plus index plus little middle plus 1. So, and the secondary classification is based on the pattern of right and left index finger. Capital letters are assigned to denote the pattern type. A is used for both plane and tented arc. W is used for all types of whorls. However, R is used for radial loop and L is used for ulnar loop. Right index finger pattern is placed in numerator and the left in denominator. The small letters A, T and R are used for arc, tented arc and radial loop to designate patterns if they occur on the thumb or the middle finger. So the middle finger pattern is represented in small letter on the immediate right side of the index finger pattern, and fingerprint pattern is shown on the immediate left side of the index finger. So there is a sub-secondary classification within the secondary classification, which is done keep in consideration the pattern type, the index, middle and ring fingers. And the final system of classification, only the loops appearing on the little finger is used. First, right finger is examined for the presence of loop. If present, its ridge count is mentioned as numerator. However, if loop does not exist on the right little finger, then left little finger is examined for loop. If present, its ridge count is mentioned as denominator. If neither right nor left little finger bear loop pattern, then final classification is not done. And if both the little fingers have loop, then only right finger ridge count is mentioned. So in rare case, final classification is also done on the basis of whorl pattern on the little finger. However, the rules are for counting the ridge count is different. There is another classification called key, which consists of the ridge count of the first loop that appears on the 10 print cards. So loop patterns on the little finger is not counted, as it is used in the final classification. If none of the finger be a loop, then key classification system is dropped. So the key is always represented as numerator. So the sequence for displaying the 10 digit classification major system is first key, then major, then primary, then secondary, then sub-secondary, and lastly the final. Till now we have discussed about the fingerprints and its classification, but dermatography is incomplete without talking about the palm prints. So let's briefly discuss about it. Palm prints are equally important as fingerprint, as they can be used for establishing identity. The palm print has same ridges features like ridge end, enclosure, bifurcation, etc. like fingerprint, but differs from fingerprints in having variety of creases. The palmar region is subdivided into three regions, namely interdigit, hypothinner and thinner. So the interdigital region is the palmar region just under the fingers. This is further subdivided into volar pad 2, 3 and 6. So the volar pad 2 is the region between the index and middle fingers, and the volar pad 3 region is the space between the middle and ring fingers. Why volar pad 6 is the reason between last two fingers. For the purpose of formulation of main line, the palm is divided into 13 regions and symbols and number are assigned to each region. So the interdigital region is characterized by the presence of deltas named as A, B, C and D in radio ulnar sequence. The radial line emerging from these triradii are further named as capital A, capital B, capital C and capital D. These radiant line trace to find out in which region of the palm it ends. Accordingly, its number are assigned, which constitutes main line formula. So the formula is recorded in the order of DCBA. Another prominent delta known as T, that is triradius, is also found occurs in the proximal region of palm at the imaginary intersection of hypothenar and thenar region. So what are these regions? Actually, hypothenar is that area which lies toward ulnar position of the palm. So the elevation in this region is termed as hypothenar eminence. Volar pad 1 exists in the hypothenar region between index finger and thumb. So likewise, the area that lies towards the thumb portion is called as the thenar, having thenar eminence. So the variety of patterns are found on hypothenar and comparatively lesser pattern exists on thenar eminence, just like fingerprints. Latent prints or fragmentary prints, which are routinely encountered at the scene of crime, are analyzed by trained and skilled experts who developed a sense of judgment in identifying the region and patterns with their experience. For matching of complete palm prints or for personal identification record purpose, main line formula is derived. Sole print is another important aspect of dermatoglyphics. So the friction ridges on the sole of the feet are as important as friction ridges on finger and palm. So like the finger and palm prints, sole prints are also used for personal identification and identification of latent prints. However, the difference in ridge flow and pattern types leads to formulation of different type of classification system for prints from the plantar surface, that is sole of the foot. Just like palmar surface, the plantar surface can be divided into 8 areas that help in the classification of prints, that is direction. Distal region is the area towards the toes, whereas proximal region is area towards the heel. So the region of the foot towards the inner side of the body is thenar, while the region towards the outside of the body is hypothenar. So that is hallucal. Hallucal area consists of interdigit area 1, that is area between great toe and long toe, and the distal thenar area. So the area consists of variety of patterns like loops, whorls and arcs. The remaining 3 interdigital areas, namely 2, 3 and 4, are the regions between long toe and third toe. So the third toe and fourth toe, and finally between fourth and little toe respectively. The interdigital areas bear triradii, deltas, and have same designation as A, B, C and D for the deltas existing under long toe, third toe, fourth toe and little toe respectively. However, sole print also have a triradius designated as E under the great toe, which has no corresponding triradius in the palm. Hypothenar, the region of the foot towards outer side of the body is called as hypothenar. So depending on its direction toward proximal and distal region, it is further categorized as distal and proximal hypothenar. Mostly horizontally flowing ridges occur in these regions. Thenar, the region of the foot towards the inner side of the body is called as the thinner or tibia thinner region and follow the same classification as hypothinner region into distal and proximal areas of foot. So the region bears large number of creases and has similar ridge patterning like hypothinner area. Interestingly, wedge-shaped ridges flow pattern occurs very frequently on the proximal thinner region towards the beginning of heel region. Calcar is the heel region. Straight horizontally flowing ridges are found on the region and rarely any pattern is seen. Toes. Just like fingerprints, toe prints also exhibit patterns like arcs, whorls, and loops. However, they differ from fingerprints in the frequency distribution of pattern types. So, arcs are the more common found, followed by loops and whorls on the toes. Though sole prints were being used for identification purposes for over 100 years, but recent knowledge on the sole print is still limited. Latent sole prints of small size are usually confused with palm prints. Recording the prints also poses another problem as big toe is generally flat and only tips can be recorded in case of other toes. Nevertheless, sole prints are as important as friction ridges prints from the other surfaces of the body and research should be conducted to strengthen this area of science. Now in the end, let's summarize what we have gone through in this module. Dermatoglyphics is the scientific study of prints or impressions formed from the surface of palm, fingers, sole and toes. So these impressions are formed when perspiration discharged from the sweat glands along with dead skin cells, proteins, fats and material creates impression of the ridges on the surface of contact. So the friction ridges first appear between 12th and 16th week of gestational age of embryo and estimated to be complete by 24th week of gestation. The prints are unique, permanent and can be classified. Fingerprints bear important features such as core and delta, which are used in its classification as arc, loop and whorl patterns. Apart from this, specific ridge features called as minutiae can be analyzed for comparison and identification purpose. To ease the process of fingerprint comparisons with many record prints, Henry's system of classification was formulated, which consists of divisions namely primary, secondary, subsecondary, final, key and major system. Palm prints are equally important as fingerprint as they can be used for establishing identity. Identification of mainline formula is one of the popular method of palm print analysis. Another important category of dermatoglyphic prints is sole print. Like the finger and palm prints, the sole prints are also used for personal identification and analysis of latent prints. However, the difference in ridge flow and pattern types leads to the formulation of different types of classification system for prints from the plantar surface of the foot. Thank you.